The past few decades have been pivotal for enabling large-scale genomics with rapid advances in computing technology, creation of high-throughput data processing methods, and availability of mass information storage. With our ability to acquire, understand, and make use of large data sequences evolving beside our knowledge of genetics, many of mankind's pursuits to conquer human biology have proven successful, starting from the discovery of our genetic basis. In 1987, the first generation comprehensive human genetic map was created, which was updated in 1992 as part of the Human Genome Project. This project was pivotal to human genetics, resulting in the first ever complete human genome sequence in 2003. Since then, advancements in high-throughput sequencing methods have enabled over 1.5 million human sequences to be completed and stored for use in research, of which the UK Biobank contributes close to 500,000. The UK Biobank is an open-source database which details the genotypic, environmental, and lifestyle factors of all participants who are aged between 49 to 60 years. Each participant provided physical measurements, blood, urine, and saliva samples for DNA testing, body imaging, and qualitative information on socio-demographic, health, and lifestyle factors. Biomarkers and genotyping arrays were used to capture genome-wide variations such as insertion deletions, single nucleotide polymorphisms, and variation in allele frequencies. Quality control tests were performed to validate genotyping results. Mismatches between self-identified and genetically inferred gender found clerical errors or sample mishandling. Comparison of allele frequencies against other databases with similar population ethnicities also identified errors in genotyping arrays, sequence mapping errors, or even more complex variation. The tests also revealed trends and biases in the data. Firstly, identifying minor alleles was inaccurate because it was difficult to distinguish between rarity and discrepancies. Secondly, genetic relatedness showed poor ancestral diversity in the sample population, with around twice as many sibling pairs than statistically reasonable. Participation in the project was therefore believed to be heavily influenced by family members. Haplotype estimation and genomic imputation was also performed on reliable datasets, focusing on the major histocompatibility complex region on chromosome 6 as it contains the largest associations with common diseases. This created over 96 million genetic variants. Imputed data from 343,000 participants was used to find statistical association between biomarkers and standing height, which confirmed imputation accuracy by comparison to giant consortium data. Giant was also used to assess credibility of the UK Biobank in general. Covering a much larger number of biomarkers, the resolution size of a credible dataset in the UK Biobank was larger but featured a smaller proportion of single nucleotide polymorphisms. Health-related outcomes and records are currently being tracked long-term for all participants in order to relate age-related phenotypic changes to genomic data. Since its release in 2012, data generated from the UK Biobank project has delivered significant results in reverse translational research. For example, machine learning strategies have used biobank data as inputs to train models to develop personalized treatments. Most peculiarly, studies on sex chromosome aneuploidy have solved the mystery behind the missing Y chromosome in white blood cells affecting 1 in 5 men aged 80+. Survival of these cells despite a missing chromosome has helped identify 19 regulatory regions involved in cell division errors, also heavily involved in cancer. The deep genotypic and phenotypic data obtained from this study has been revolutionary for the field of genetics for three key reasons. Firstly, it will accurately and systematically inform the genetic basis of specific common diseases. Using reverse genetics to identify key targets for gene regulation is expected to be largely error-free compared to conventional forward genetics methods, which focus on narrow regions within the genome related to the disease of interest. The potential to accelerate and progress translational research in epidemiology is now enormous. Secondly, using reverse translational research will improve risk prediction strategies across a population with varying susceptibility to diseases. Accurately predicting at-risk individuals allows for early detection of diseases and preventative measures if necessary. Thirdly, the open-source nature of the UK Biobank engages people across continents and industries to combine their knowledge and resources towards better research and clinical outcomes. The more collaborative workspace combines various skill sets to further research and innovative capacities within the genetic field. 8 years from its release, the UK Biobank project continues to open doors to new avenues in genetics.